usage of digital technology, accuracy, and regular taking of mock tests. These are the three things which have played a big role in getting Rajendran rank 1 in SEBI Grade A 2018. Today I have Rajendran with us, who is going to share his strategy as to what are the do's and don'ts that he followed in phase 1, phase 2 and interview of SEBI Grade A 2018, and what are the tips and tricks that you can follow in order to improve your performance in the upcoming examination.
Hi, I'm Rajendran and I have secured rank 1 in SEBI Grade A 2018 examination. I'm here to share my strategy, my experience, and based on my experience, do's and don'ts to crack this examination. And I would like to thank Anuj Jindal Sir for inviting me for this session.
Hello everyone, I have Rajendran with me today, who secured rank 1 in SEBI Grade A 2018. And first of all, I would like to congratulate you and thank you for coming all the way from Puducherry in order to share your strategy. So what we are going to do today is, it's going to be very specific, very much on the face. We are going to focus upon the things that he did, the things that he did not do, consciously, subconsciously, and how did he prepare for SEBI examination. So the strategy is going to be useful only, not only for SEBI, but also for the upcoming RBI and NABARD examinations. First of all, let me share your marks with the students and then we'll move forward. He scored, in securities market, he scored 82.5 out of 100. In ESI and FM, which is one paper in SEBI, he scored 83 on 100. In English, he scored 74 and in interview, 11 on 15. So the total score was 239.5 on 300 without the interview. Now, one very interesting thing that I've noticed is all the marks are almost equal to the highest marks, if not the highest, almost there. So in SM, you were 82.5. What was the highest there?
85.
85 was the highest. In ESI and FM, you got 83. The highest
was around 90.
Around 90. And in English, you got 74. The highest was?
Around 80.
Around 80. So as you can see here, although he did not get the highest marks, which I also thought for a while that, okay, how did he score? How did he get rank 1? No highest marks. But then I saw that, okay, the marks are all, all the marks are as good as highest. So that matters a lot. That
Sir,
shows.
I would like to point out that we should not focus on one single paper or one single subject.
Uh-huh.
We have to give equal importance to all the papers so that even if we don't have a good day on one of the papers or if it's difficult, we can get a good mark and somehow make it to the final list.
Right.
I think people sometimes focus on, if they like security markets very much, they try to do a PhD in it. That is not necessary. Whatever is necessary to clear the examination, even if we don't get the highest mark, if we can clear it, that will be good.
Equal focus is important. Then that shows in your marks. You focused equally on all the papers. Okay, jumping directly to phase one. In the starting of the video, I told you three things and we'll be coming back to those three things and also show you and prove to you the importance of those three things based upon his strategy. But let me come to phase one directly. So when it comes to QA, reasoning and English, he had the same strategy for all three. So let me start by asking you, how exactly did you practice for all these three things and what did you do out here?
Yes, sir, I gave three mock tests. One was with Anuj Jindal and another two more institutes. I gave phase one mock tests and I attempted all tests. I didn't skip even single test. If there were 10 tests, I attempted all 10 tests and dedication is important. I think sometimes we just attempt a part of it. We do not cover. We do not cover every section. Maybe we skip some sections. I attempted all sections with the perfect timing. And more than attempting, I think after clicking the submit button, it doesn't end there. We have to analyze our performance, find out newer information from those answers and from those PDFs, and then insert them into, I used OneNote for making notes, and whatever new point or a new concept which I came across, I just put them in the OneNote, and in that way, analysis of mocks really helped me.
Practice
is one part of it, and analysis is very, very important. And I think many people miss out here. They just practice it. Even if you get the top rank in those mocks, still we have a lot of areas of improvement.
Right.
And I think by improving, we can ensure that we not just clear, we clear with confidence and with a big margin.
So what you did was you analyzed these mocks.
Analyzed these mocks.
And you used digital notes for
digital
this.
Digital notes. I just put them, suppose if there is a new point about RBI or if there is a new point about, say, inflation.
Hmm.
Suppose I don't know about the producer's price index, if there is a concept.
Hmm.
I just take a screen clipping of it and put that in my chapter called as inflation. So when I come across the next time, I just revise it so that whatever marks I have given, it doesn't go waste and it is part of my preparation revision for the next one.
So this is one thing that students miss out a lot. They don't, number one, they don't analyze the marks, and number two, at the same time, they don't use digital notes. Well, it's a digital world.
I think it's digital. Some people have preference for handwritten notes. It's up to their choice. But as far as digital is concerned, taking notes and revision becomes easier.
Much easier
than handwritten notes. And also managing a lot of papers and a lot of notebooks is difficult. Whereas if it's going to be digital, it's going to be just a single PDF or single OneNote. It's easy.
Yeah, and I understand that a lot of students are used to, using handwritten notes, and they don't want to change it.
And I think change is a part of something which we have to consciously develop. Even I was reluctant initially to go for digital notes, but later I realized it is far more time saving and I can learn a lot, because as far as mock tests are concerned, if I'm going to write it down separately, it will take another 4-5 hours to analyze that mock. But whereas here I can finish it off in an hour, 2 hours of mock, 1 hour or 1 hour of analysis. And that is it. We are done with our mocks. And
so you're saving 3 hours.
Saving 3 hours.
And at the same time, getting back is going to be...
That is going to be productive mock test, which will be helpful for us in the real examination.
You're right. That actually is very important. And what about time management? How did you learn this?
Yes, sir. Time management is very, very crucial. And I think before time management, we have to know our strengths and weaknesses. For me, reasoning and aptitude was slightly difficult for me. Difficult in the sense I took a long time to solve those questions, aptitude questions. So I kept reasoning and aptitude in the beginning. I completed it and then moved over to English, general awareness and securities market. And in a way, I managed time so that I know my weakness, I just try to play around it.
And for this, let's say QA, reasoning and English part, did you also maintain these notes in digital format or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, you did.
Suppose I come across a new type, say for example, coding, a new type of coding is there, I just put them into this note. So that let me just revise it or practice it before the examination. Even for phase one, it's better to maintain a separate note for...
Separate notes.
Yes.
And I think if you're making digital notes, then simultaneously you're also, getting done with English for phase two. Because a lot of students have this problem that they're very slow at typing. And I think when you're making these notes...
In these examinations, we are going to type. So digital will be the preferred one and the best one.
Yes.
And typing in SEBI, there is only 1 hour time for phase two English exam. So typing speed
has to be higher.
So this will be helping us.
So what you're doing, you're basically, having multiple advantages. English for phase two is done. You don't have to spend time on... increasing your time speed, then you're saving time directly, because when you want to revisit these analysis of these mocks, it saves time. And at the same time, when you're analyzing these mocks on paper, it takes probably 3 hours. Here it is taking only 1 hour.
Where we have written that and those kind of problems. And in OneNote, it's easy. If you just type that word, even if I don't remember where I have written producers price and just type producers, it will show pages.
It will show.
So in that way, it will be very much helpful.
It's much easier. Okay, so that was about phase one. I think let's keep it short and sweet. Let's come to GA. Okay, GA is left for phase one. So what are these things? Can you explain these things online?
Since I was working, I didn't have much time to do a daily based current affairs reading. And so I picked up sources like monthly current affairs compilation. And I just stick to one or two sources. I didn't do more than that. But that one PDF, if it's, suppose it's for this month of April, I just revise it 5 to 6 times so that I don't even leave one point in it. Because in GA, I scored 70, GA and securities market, I scored 70 out of 80. My total score was 126. So I just scored 56 in English,
QA
and reasoning. So this was my strength, and so I wanted to make sure that I score high in this area. So I picked up one source and I revised it completely, and then through mock tests I just added extra current affairs, whatever is available in other test series. I just read them and then inserted them in OneNote as usual, and then I revised them. And the important part is there is also static part in general awareness, and I think people miss out on this. They just think that it's over if they do that monthly current affairs compilation, etc. Static part is important, and I think even before the notification comes, if one can finish off the static part, that would be very much helpful. For example, current countries, currencies, capitals, I don't think that requires much of help or anything. You can finish it off. Geography related, national parks, dams, etc. Those things can be finished, and that is important also. We get at least some 6 to 7 questions in SEBI, and in RBI this is almost like 10 to 15 questions.
You are right.
Static part.
And it's the same for all 3-4 exams that you have.
So
that is also an advantage, right? You do it once. When you start with general awareness, I think the first thing that you do is cover the static part and then move to monthly current. Okay, so what about this read aloud and revision?
As I mentioned earlier, I just pick up one source, it will be a PDF, for example, Bank Aseda compilation, and I read it once, and then I switch on read aloud option in PDF, so that I need not spend time whenever I'm bored or whenever I'm tired, the computer will do the business for me, it will read, and then I just take it into my head. Revision part becomes easier with read aloud option. So because of making digital notes or using digital material, our revision becomes a lot more simpler. And I think revision is the most important thing.
So that's another advantage of using digital notes that I think we can. So revision is much more easier.
Much more easier.
Because instead of reading the same thing again, you are using, you know, a text to speech kind of a thing, wherein the computer is reading out the same thing for you. So I think that's very important. Students should be using digital modes like you have used more and more. So these are the main things about general awareness.
To put it in two words, I think practice and revision, these two things are very much important to clear phase one.
So to keep it in mind, let's shorten it further, PR. That's what you need to keep in mind, practice and revision. Practice as much as possible through mocks, analyze those mocks. So analysis of mocks is a part of practice. And then revise, keep revising the same thing again and again. I think that's the key that Rajendran is trying to put across, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we're done with phase one broad analysis. Now let's move to phase two analysis. So we are going to start with ESI. We're going to move towards FM, and then we'll talk about securities market for SEBI. Let me just reiterate this point. He got a total of 83 on 100 in ESI and FM combined. Okay. Okay, Rajendran. So what are these things?
Yes, sir. As far as SEBI is concerned, we have ESI and FM as a combined paper. And so the number of questions is just 50, which means 25 for ESI and 25 for FM. So let us start off with the ESI current affairs. I think that is more important than static part for, as far as SEBI, at least for SEBI is concerned. And in current affairs, it is important to do whatever is coming in the newspaper and maybe monthly compilation of Anuj Jindal. And if we have specific current affairs specific for phase two is different from phase one, I think people get confused. Sometimes they think that phase one and phase two are related. But then here we have a lot of things related to government schemes and reports, documents released. And for example, recently Niti Aayog has come out with Vision India at 75 document. Those kinds of documents are very, very important, and be rest assured there will be a question on this document. And then on SDG goals, Niti Aayog has released, and so documents which are released by the government are very, very important, and so cover them in current affairs. And then reports and indices, reports like Human Development Index and Multidimensional Poverty Index. And all those indices are important. Don't leave any index, because we don't know which index they will be asking. They will be asking maybe rank or score obtained or parameters of that index. And so doing that is very important. I think you had given out a PowerPoint of all those indices with ranks, etc. That was very helpful. And so finish off reports and indices.
So these are the things that you can do one by one because they're topic wise.
Yes,
current affairs, Niti Aayog is one topic wise. Reports and indices entire topic wise. So you can finish off these things one by one. Okay.
And schemes are very, very important, sir. Not just current schemes, even they are schemes launched earlier, older ones. And we have to do them completely. At least, I think in schemes, we can select chapters also. For example, poverty, that is an important chapter. And then employment. In those chapters, we have a lot of schemes. Those get asked very often.
In those areas.
In those areas.
Yes.
And then very, very important is education, schemes related to education, schemes related to health, women. And I think these, first of all, let us finish off important schemes and then move on to some unrelated or
probably culture and all those things can be covered later.
New Year schemes plus schemes on these topics.
On these topics.
Those have to be finished. And then, as you keep saying, sir, acronyms are very, 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 very important, sir. This time, I think they asked two questions on acronyms and SEBI. And we have to somehow remember those acronyms. Be it Pradhan Mantri Jan Dhan, that is easy. Some, for example, PMAAY, they ask like that. And they asked to expand HRDE, Heritage Regeneration and Development. And those kind of acronyms. So we have to do them completely, schemes and acronyms. And the important part is economic survey and budget. We will get questions on that. That is also part of current affairs or extra apart from static part. You have to do that. And it's not necessary to remember the budgetary allocation for every particular scheme. I think people, students keep asking, should we remember every scheme? Fund allocated for every scheme, etc. I think important schemes, if we remember.
Important schemes and important areas.
Important.
Like infra, how much, health, how much. So all those things can
that will do. And economic survey is very, very important document. I think economic survey is also, will also be helpful for interview. Because, for example, if they have launched some, for example, Jam Trinity, they may ask, will it be helpful? What are the issues with that? And so they would have analyzed in depth in economic survey. And those two are important.
So not only the facts related or mentioned in the survey, but
there
also
are a lot of, since it is being written by chief economic advisor, it will be analytical. So it will help us for interview also. So it is not just for phase two alone, it is helpful for interview also.
And I think the same is going to be
yes, sir.
Because this year the survey is not out.
Yes, sir.
So Niti Aayog can play the same role. And I am very, very sure all these, you know, people who are taking the interviews, all these people
would have read that.
Would have read these things.
Would have read this document, so it's important. And then the, again, once again, importance of mocks. I cannot reiterate more than this. I'll put how many ever stars necessary for mocks, because it is not just attempting. People think that, okay, it's just an MCQ. I know the answer. They have given the answer. It's just about choosing, but it's about learning. Even if we don't know an option, if we can know what is that particular scheme, it is learning for us. It is a new information. And I used to put those information in OneNote, as I said earlier. From here, I think new information or data has to be transferred to OneNote. And that is the best way to utilize these mock tests. And I think people can go for any number of mock tests. I won't say just stick to one particular test series. Stick to one particular source for preparation, but then as far as giving mocks are concerned, you, they can take as many mocks.
As many mocks. And, and it's always better to go for multiple
mocks. Because if I read current affairs from one particular institute and attempt that particular mock test, I think it will be very easy.
Yes.
Because they will be, most probably we know the mindset of that particular examiner, and then questions will be similar.
On the same lines.
Guess it. But if we attend mock test of a different institute, it will be helpful for us to know new information, new areas. They might give importance for some other areas. So it will be always helpful to attend mocks of different institutes.
So you're basically going, you know, reading minds of multiple teachers, multiple educators, multiple mentors.
I gave mocks in three institutes. I think at the end of the day, out of 50 questions, maybe 40 to 45 questions would have been from those mocks.
From those.
At least those areas. If not the exact question, marks will be from those areas. So that will be very much helpful.
That is very helpful. Okay.
And then social issues, I think social issues gets covered in current affairs itself. Education, health, these are the important things in social issues, human issues. And apart from that, two topics are Indian political system and then social justice and social movements. These are the three other topics.
Yes.
And I don't think they will ask a lot of questions on Indian political system.
Not at all. They have skipped it completely.
Social justice will generally be scheme based.
Yes.
We have covered that in schemes itself. Social movements alone, I think you have given a very good PDF, sir. Crisp PDF. It was a PPT. And I did only that. And I think there was one question about a movement in SEBI. I don't remember the exact question. I think that is more than enough. We need not go to different sources, refer books, etc. Doing one particular source and then attempting different mocks.
Attempting different mocks, I think that does the job.
And we are left out with static. And As far as static is concerned, I don't think people who have a background, those who have done UPSC preparation, I think they will be comfortable. They can skip over the static part. Apart from, for others, maybe growth and development, human development, poverty, employment, and then fiscal and monetary policy. I think these 4 or 5 chapters will do. If they have time, they can go for static. They can refer to one basic book. Maybe it may be Ramesh Singh or Mishra and Puri, whatever book they are comfortable.
So I think for static portion, things like macroeconomics, because they've started asking questions from macroeconomics, because it covers monetary policy and fiscal policy, right?
Yes, sir.
And then you have the things that you're talking about, social issues. No, social issues.
Human development.
Human development. What else did you mention?
Poverty, employment.
Poverty, employment. So all these, let's say, what has been the evolution, or how has been the evolution of
they ask, sometimes they ask about Tendulkar committee.
Yes.
The parameter used in Tendulkar committee's report. Or what was the poverty ratio in Tendulkar committee and Rangarajan committee, something they can compare two committees. And so we cannot skip those theoretical part or those, static part of
yes. Let's say Mahalanobis model, they ask about when was it introduced, what was it, or development financial institutions, how were they
That is IMF and World Bank, they keep asking, and WTO.
Yes.
They are part of static.
They are part of static only.
Though they get covered under current affairs, they may ask what are those part of WTO, what are the important documents, agreement on agriculture, subsidies, etc. There may be a question. So it's better to do at least a basic of it.
At least a
and
basic.
I would say don't skip even a single topic in the syllabus. Cover all those topics, at least know something about it. That will be very much helpful, sir.
So students can just, even if they're not using anything else, just Google
just
that topic.
Google the topic and that will be as you
said. That will, I think, will be enough. Okay, now let's move to FM part.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so you can start explaining the FM part one by one.
I think as far as finance and management is concerned, there are two parts, finance and management. And I think equal emphasis is needed for both finance and management. They ask, out of 25 questions in FM, they asked almost 10 to 12 questions from management and rest of the 13 questions were from finance.
Equal weightage.
Equal weightage. And the management is very, very easy for anyone. They need not have any specialization, even for people from non-finance, non-economic background. This is very easy. Cover this first and do this very well. And I think your notes are more than enough, comprehensive notes. And doing those important theories in leadership, motivation, those are the important topics. Finish them off and they can be rest assured of 10 to 12 questions, which means 20 to 25 marks.
20 to 25. So if in you're management. Done with the syllabus in management, you're through.
Yes.
So I think that's one of the easiest areas.
Easiest there. Areas and most scoring areas.
Most
questions
scoring.
Will be direct. We need not get confused. And in finance, it's technical, little bit technical. Whereas in management, it is just easy.
Very generic.
Very generic.
You're right. You can relate to it because it's connected with your everyday
life. And it will
life.
Be helpful once we enter the organization, motivational theory, leadership theory. We can use them.
Right.
We can know what are the different styles of leadership, how can we use it effectively. So it will help for us, not just for this examination, but also for our own development.
So we were just talking about the leadership styles of various, let's say, politicians in your area, in Puducherry. So we were connecting it with management theories. So that way you can bring it to life by connecting it with some of the other thing. Okay, let's move to finance theory.
That is very important. Finance, as far as finance theory is concerned, there are some important topics. For example, risk management, that was asked a lot this year. I think they asked questions in Basel norms.
Basel, yes.
Basel norms. And then they asked about repo, reverse repo. Though they, and I think a part of it also gets covered in economics and social issues. Don't skip it. Monetary policy and fiscal policy can also be asked in finance.
Yes.
And I think there were questions in finance paper also. So repo, reverse repo, and they asked questions about liquidity adjustment facilities. And I think in this SEBI examination this year, it was okay. There were a lot of technical questions, those things related to RBA, for example, repo, reverse repo, LAF, etc. And risk management is an important topic. And apart from that, numericals, as far as numericals is concerned, I think bonds, time value of money, and then cost of capital.
So basically entire financial management.
Financial management. I think people will find ratios a little bit difficult.
Difficult,
ratios
yes.
And balance sheet. People from non-finance background,
It's difficult to understand.
It's difficult for them to understand. And I think they can skip these two topics, but at least have a working knowledge of it. Let them know what is the basic thing. If they have an easy question, we should not skip any question in the examination.
Right.
If they have an easy question, they have to attempt it to that extent. And I think time value of money, bonds, etc. are easier. So if they focus on these areas and even leave out these areas, that will be helpful. And finance theory, generally, it's enough if we do a course material of one institute. We need not go for any other books, because they are a lot from an academic point of view instead of from an examination point of view.
You're right.
So doing a course material of one institute plus mock tests will suffice for it. And current affairs is all very, very important in finance.
Because from where did you cover this?
From current affairs, I covered in your course material, current affairs, and I used one more institute's material also. I think not more than two sources, but I, as I said earlier, I used three mock tests. From that, whatever were new information, I just transferred them to my one note.
Yes. So you're, by taking multiple mock tests, I think you're simultaneously covering the entire course material of those multiple institutes, right?
Because when they ask questions in the test series, it will be generally tougher than the regular ones, whatever they have in regular course material.
Okay, what about the newspaper? You mentioned something about the newspaper.
Newspaper is important for phase 2 and phase 3. Maybe for phase 1 you can skip newspaper. Phase 2 and interview. Because generally they ask passages directly from a newspaper. I think some people ask they don't have time to cover newspaper. But what I would suggest is, if suppose there is a news item related to repo rate or monetary policy bi-monthly review by RBI, it will be mentioned definitely in your course, current affairs course material. I just Google it. I just Google the topic, and whatever is covered in, say, for example, Hindu or in Economic Times, I just read that passage, and those passages are directly lifted in the examination. You will have just dash. You will, for example,
just fill in the blank in between.
For example, this time World Bank had come out with ease of doing business report, and those, that paragraph was lifted from the newspaper. So how many indicators we can cover it, but if we cover it from the original source, it will be helpful.
It will be helpful.
Like how dash indicators, and India was ranked dash. What does expansion of DTF, what does F mean in DTF, etc. So newspaper, if possible, doing it will be very good. Or otherwise, whatever current affairs material you follow, just pick the topic, Google it, and then get the original version of
it. So I think that's an interesting thing, and that's something new that even I did not follow. I would not have followed if I was preparing. That is, you know, going through a particular course, whatever is being provided by someone, and then Googling the same thing and coming to the passage which might be asked in the final examination. So in short, you are actually covering
the news, important items in the newspaper. Though I'm skipping the newspaper, I'm covering important items.
Covering the important items, and that is going to help you in the exam directly also, not indirectly. So that's something new that you guys can note down. Okay, so we're done with ESI and FM. Anything specific or anything that you feel is left out? Otherwise, we can move to the securities market part.
And I think ESI and FM is a huge subject. It's a huge subject. I think people start off with ESI and FM. They take some books. For example, if they take Mishra and Puri, economics is vast. Or if they go for Prasanna Chandra for finance, it is fast. I think a particular course material is more than enough to clear this. Because I didn't read any books, or I just did Ramesh Singh for economics in my UPSC preparation. That's all. I just followed one course material, but multiple mocks. That is the strategy for ESI and FM.
I think that's a very good strategy, because you're covering multiple courses at the same time by, you know, taking mocks from different people, taking mocks from different institutes. And that's very interesting also. Okay, so let's move to securities market now. So we are done with ESI and FM of phase 2. Now let's move to securities market. Let me reiterate, his score here was 82.5 on 100. Almost highest, the highest was around 85, I believe.
85.
So let us take through whatever you have created here in order to explain how to cover securities markets.
Yes, sir. Actually, it has two parts, securities markets and securities laws. Both are interconnected, you cannot skip it. And most of the questions in phase 1 are from securities market. And so this gets covered in securities market phase 1. So it's easier for phase 2 also. So prepare simultaneously. And then laws, especially securities laws related to these topics, are asked in phase 2. So preparation for phase one and phase two should be simultaneous as far as SEBI is concerned. And in securities market, some of the topics will help you in finance and management of RBA or other exams also. So it is not that this part is only helpful for SEBI, because it is related capital market. Part of capital market is what SEBI is regulating. And so this will be helpful for other exams too. But as far as phase two is concerned, securities laws portion will be specific for SEBI exam alone. And in securities market, we have divided it into topics so that it will be easy for us to analyze. And first is capital market and participants in it. For example, stock exchanges, companies, and market infrastructure, depositories, etc. We cover it under capital market. And then we have intermediaries, brokers, share transfer agents, and then merchant bankers, etc. And then we have the regulator, which is the SEBI, which is going to regulate this capital market or securities market to be in specific. And we have also securities appellate tribunal as part of regulator. And then we have different kinds of instruments. Instruments includes here bonds, a debt instrument, equity instrument, and hybrid instruments. And apart from that, we have something now which is very, very popular, commodities market. We hear a lot of about commodities market, agriculture commodities market. It can help our farmers. So this area has not been touched upon by SEBI. So far, but this is a very, very important area.
Expected to be.
To be important.
Important in the future, yes.
And then we have two very important ongoing
instruments,
which is InvIT and REITs. This is for real estate and this is for infrastructure. This is to attract funding for those two sectors. Because since they have a longer gestation period, fund flow requires a longer duration. Maturity is longer. And so SEBI is promoting these two. And so expect questions from these two areas.
And the regulation also attached to this.
This is this has been in news recently for different reasons. And we have securities laws related to these topics, sir. For example, we have securities for regulator, we have SEBI Act, we have Securities Contract Regulation Act, and we have Act for SAT, Securities Appellate Tribunal, and we have Depositories Act for depository, and these two regulations, these two ICDR, issue of capital and disclosure regulation, and listing
LODR,
we have LODR regulation. I think these two regulations are very, very important as far as phase two is concerned. Maybe we may not have questions in phase one from these regulations, but these are very, very important. And as far as phase one is concerned, expect questions from securities market, not generally from securities law. But as far as phase two is concerned, as we have said, questions are factual in nature. Questions are very specific in nature. Unless you cover these important regulations, it is difficult to attempt it.
So the division is, you know, amazing. It's pretty beautiful. So what we have done is this part is phase one. And at the same time, all these areas which are covered in phase one are also have a connecting law with everything. So it, you can actually cover these laws simultaneously, or you can cover them separately also if you want to. But you can make a division of your entire prep like this in order to make it more interesting and more relatable. And then there are the kinds of questions that are being asked this year, and probably they'll expand into something more. But they, these were the kinds of questions. So let's have an explanation on these.
Yes, sir. What happened is I subscribed to your course and had done securities market. That PDF was wonderful. But as far as securities law is concerned, even if you subscribe to your course, it is important to do those documents in original, read them in original. Because what happens is, questions which are asked this time, I'll read out some of the questions which have been asked this year. They had asked a question on when did LODR come into effect, date they had asked, and then they had asked a question on SEBI Act. When did it come into force?
The date.
The date, exact date when it was published. And so we have to do them, do these acts in full, in original. That is important.
That's because it's impossible to, you know, cover them in the course And at the same
time,
I
think we cannot provide a summary of those acts.
Yes.
We can just explain it as a concept. This specific section covers this specific topic, but we cannot make a summary of it. That act is act. We cannot simplify it.
Yes.
So read it in original. That will be helpful. Just do these 5 to 6 acts. That is Depository Act, SEBI Act, SERA, ICDR, LODR. That is more than enough. Five acts in original.
They will do the
work. And then they had asked about sections. There are questions about section. For example, rights issue is a part of which section of ICDR? So
those are things which cannot be
given in a summary sheet or cannot be given in a PDF. So it has to be done in that document itself. And then there were questions on amounts. For example, net worth of a stockbroker. And there was a question on net worth of a registrar and share transfer agent. So those factual data are very, very important as far as phase two is concerned. So don't ignore them. I think some people got low marks in security issues because they had studied only conceptual part of it and they had skipped on factual part. I think cover them completely.
Cover the factual part completely, especially these amounts and dates and sections. They're going to be even more intense in the future, because if they're asking these things, they're going to continue.
Because they cannot ask something conceptual in an act or in
an act.
Because this is the syllabus, we have majority of security laws in phase two. And so they should be asking something related to it.
Right. And what about the conceptual questions?
And conceptual questions were generally related to securities market. They had questions on, for example, conceptual question is, there are certain questions I don't get them, but then they asked conceptual questions too. So don't skip concepts. Some people focus only on facts and then skip the concepts. That is, concepts and facts, equal weightage should be given. And then appointments, I think we left it out in our discussion regarding ESA and FM. There were questions like, who was the chief economist, who was appointed as chief economist of IMF? That was a phase one question. It was Geeta Gopinath. So asked in phase two of ESA. So as far as ESA and also security mark, here they are asked question about who is the chairman of SEBI and
chairman of SAT, I believe.
Chairman of SAT and how are they appointed? There were questions like that.
So those are actually phase one areas which are covered in Spotlight and some other magazines. But they are being asked in phase 2 also, when it comes to SEBI exam specially. And I think that can continue. So don't miss out on these 3-4 marks in phase 2.
And I think since there are only 50 questions, if we miss out on 5 questions, it means we are getting only 90. So if you miss out 90, you attempt only 45, you will get 90. And you will anyway make 3 to 4 mistakes. So it will come down to 80, 70, 75. And I think doing each and every topic and attempting questions with accuracy is very, very important in phase 2, sir. Since there are only 50 questions, we have to be accurate and we should not lose marks.
So let's do one thing. Conclude this session and let's come to the
Just a minute.
Yes,
I think securities market and securities law, many people think it's difficult for them.
Yes,
there is something boring or something which is very difficult or technical. Trust me, there is nothing technical as far as securities market is concerned. Even finance is a little bit tougher and technical. Security markets and securities law are generally easy. Conceptual questions related to instruments, generally they are asked, but they are easy. Only these instruments kind of things will be technical for
technical
people.
Or conceptual.
Apart from that, capital markets or intermediaries, regulators, etc., they are not technical at all.
So this is the only area which
instruments which are conceptual.
Need some more conceptually understanding or strength with respect to concepts. Other areas are simpler. I think that's a very good point that is made out, that although it looks very difficult, but it is not difficult, especially not as difficult as finance. So there in finance paper, you are actually, if you're covering finance, you're getting only, let's say, 50 marks.
Because finance numerical is technical.
Technical,
compared
very technical.
To this paper.
Yes.
So it is an easy scoring paper, I think.
So you have to spend more time on this rather than spending.
I think people spent a lot of time on ESA and FM, which is huge. But at the same time, it was also 100 marks worth. And this paper is also 100 marks worth.
Yes.
So it is important to concentrate on this paper. And then one more important thing is English. Many people skip that part, skip that paper itself, thinking that essay, prissy and comprehension is very easy. But I think we should spend time. I attempted all your tests, sir. I didn't skip even single test and all the questions. I just had a gist of, at least a summary for all the questions.
All the essay topics.
All the essay topics. So when I go there, I have just 1 hour and it's just 25 minutes for a question, 20 to 25 minutes. So it's easy if we have a material at home, if we have an answer at home rather than going there.
And thinking, then creating,
structuring. And also for all those topics, I had an introduction, general introduction and a general conclusion, which I will edit depending upon the context.
Depending upon the context.
For example, if they are going to ask a question on education or health, I will just move on to human development and tell that sustainable development goals cannot be achieved unless we focus on education and health. So that will be my conclusion for those topics. So I had an introduction, conclusion, and I had some material for it.
See, that's very interesting because he's already created an answer or a model essay. Or let's say he has created 30 model essays.
Yes, sir. Exactly, to be exact.
And you know, if there are 5 essay topics, one of them is going to strike.
Sir, another point here I want to mention is the analysis of previous year papers. Sir.
Yes.
I think they keep repeating questions on financial literacy, financial inclusion, cyber security, etc. If you can have a model answer for those questions, it will be easy when you sit for the real examination.
Yes. So you need to create those model answers on your own. Let's say the points I can give you based upon the test, but the intro and conclusion, those are the things that you have to create on your own, and so that you have 30 model answers, 30 model essays.
I think no one provides English test series. I think it is available only with you, so
yes.
People generally miss out on English, and I think in SEBI they were a little bit lenient, but RBI many people missed the final cutoff because of lower marks in English.
In English.
So it's very important not to ignore English. And I think both the papers, English and security marks combined together, will give you 66% of the marks.
Right.
So people generally start off with ESA and FM and then come to this part
towards
later,
the end.
Towards the end.
Yeah.
So first finish off this, practice at least for 5 to 6 days for English, and that will be.
So if you're spending, let's say, 45 days on securities market and security law, actually, the time to be spent on English should also be 45.
Maybe a little bit lesser, maybe 35
yes,
to 40.
Yes. But that is also a lot. Let's say we reduce it to 35. 35 or 30. And students are not even spending that much time.
I think people spend maximum 3 to 4 days on
yes,
English.
Yes. So 3 to 4, let's say this is the reality and this is the ideal situation that should be there. So this is the gap that you have to fill when it comes to English. Okay, I think that's a beautiful thing that we mentioned here. So let's conclude the entire thing and bring out the important points that we have. So now we have analyzed the entire phase 2 and phase 2 strategy of Rajendran. To conclude, these are the important points that he had mentioned, and that I thought that let's repeat those points again, so that if you're sticking around and watching this video till the end, you have these important points in mind when you leave this video, and you make sure that you integrate them in your strategy from the future. Okay, so let's have an analysis of these conclusions.
Yes, sir. First part is notes making, and I think I prefer digital notes, be it OneNote or Evernote. It is easy for us to organize our notes, easy for us to read or retrieve from it, and also revise easily. So OneNote played a very, very important part in my preparation, and it helped me in organizing. Since we refer to many sources, it helped me in organizing my notes better. And so that is one of the important aspects of preparation. And second one I would say is revision. And I think many a time we spend a lot of time on gaining new information, but we don't spend time on retaining it. And I think revision is very, very key. Unless we have a hold of whatever we have studied previously, there is no point in adding new knowledge. And I think retention, retention requires revision, so it's important. And because I used OneNote, it was easy to activate read aloud option and then allow it to read for me.
So saving time, saving energy.
So many days we will, during our preparation, we may not feel like reading something. So at that time we can use this option, revise whatever we have read earlier. And then third one will be mock test. Practice. That is the key to success, sir. Even if it's just a one marker, even if it's just an MCQ based examination, practice plays a very important role. And if you attempt as many practice mocks as possible, you will have a good accuracy. Our accuracy depends on these things. And after practicing a mock, it is important to analyze it. Analysis plays an important role. What we prepare generally contributes just to 60 to 70%. Subject theory just contributes to 60 to 70% of our knowledge. And these mocks take it up to 90%, and I would say rest 10% is luck or destiny, whatever it is. And so this contributes nearly 20 to 30% of our preparation analysis of mocks. We get a lot of new information from these mock tests.
And accuracy is important because you have only 50 questions.
Because even if you miss out on 5 questions and you make a mistake in 5, it comes down to 40. And taking negative marks, we may get around something around 75.
So your score has certainly gone down.
And we lose out because number of seats, generally in what happens is, they just come out with 80 to 90 seats recruitment. And I think I want to speak a little bit about this seat. I think when SEBI came out with the recruitment, many people said just 84 seats. Just 49 for general, I think so. It was just 49 for general. And many people thought, okay, let me not give this attempt. But trust me, lesser the number of seats, lesser is the competition. Only those who are really
serious
will attempt this examination. And it's easy to beat people, say, for example, 1,000 serious aspirants than, say, around 1 lakh aspirants for UPSC. So these examinations, when there is limited number of seats available, it's easy for us to crack.
It's easier. So you have to, and you just need one seat.
That is the thing. Don't be bothered. Even if it's just one seat, even if it's just 10 seats, notifications for 10 seats, we just need one seat. And I think that should be the right mindset to begin with.
Okay. Model essays.
As far as many people neglect English, it is because they would have prepared it, they would have used English as their medium of communication for writing, etc. All along their life. So they will feel as if they can write good essays, they can be the best. But what happens here is that it is a combination of good language and content.
I think
people miss out on content. They have very good English, but sometimes their marks might be less because they have missed out on content. And so if we have model essays for say 30 to 40 topics, important topics, it will be helpful for us. We can have a good essay and that will fetch us good mark. And sometimes English can make or break your
And content does not, I think, only mean the points for body. It also means your introduction and your conclusion.
Because introduction takes your examiner deeper inside your essay, and conclusion is the time at which they are going to award marks. If your conclusion is good, if it's futuristic, then definitely you will get some 2 or 3 marks extra.
Yes.
So it's important, if possible, have a model introduction and conclusion for those topics and have a good content for this. And good content requires us to go through different articles, different newspapers. And maybe if we do not follow newspaper regularly, we can search on those topics.
Yes.
For example, I wrote an essay on climate change and whatever current affairs was related to climate change, I just googled climate change and got articles related to it and I incorporated in that.
You must have prepared something on environment or climate change in advance.
So those topics, definitely we can say that there will be a topic on economy, there will be an essay on economy, there will be an essay on social issues, there will be an essay on environment. So just be prepared with a model answer for those topics, that will be helpful.
So 30 to 40 model answers, I think it's very important.
More than enough, that will do for us. And I think next one is equal emphasis. Be it phase 1, phase 2 or interview, put an equal effort, and within phase 2, put an equal effort for all papers. You need not be a master of any particular subject. Just as they say, be a jack of all trades. That is very much important in this examination. And once we can secure good marks in all papers, I think you can easily get to.
And you are a real example of what is happening. So equal emphasis, because all three papers have 100 marks.
100 marks.
So why do you want to discriminate when all of them are going to, you know, award you based upon these 100 marks? So it's important that you have equal emphasis. So I think that's all. We've covered everything. We've revised everything. And as mentioned, revision is the key, so we've revised here also. So I think it's important that you keep these things in mind and learn some new things and integrate some new things into your preparation, because you are spending a lot of your youth preparing for these exams, and you have to take it seriously and be more strategic and focused when it comes to preparation. I would like to thank Rajendran for being here. Thank you so much.
I would also like to thank you for inviting. And I would wish you all the best for this year. You have started new initiatives like Let's Take a Test Together.
Yes.
And I think that's wonderful. And please be in touch with any at least one particular expert for guidance. And I think expert guidance is important.
Yes.
Because sometimes you may waver, choose the wrong path. Uh-huh. As you said, strategy is very important and guidance is important. Mm-hmm. And thank you, sir, for having me.
Thank you so much.
Thank
All
you.
The very best. Take care.
Thank you.